no front, no faking. That's what you be doing. And in my hood, we call that studioing.
Yo, 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 you know what it is. We back, man, with another live episode of the No Studioing Podcast, man. It's your boy, Geechi Gotti, and I'm here with my dog, Lush. Uno.
Come on, man.
You already know.
Once again.
We back, man. You know what I'm saying? The money couldn't be here today. Craig couldn't be here, man. Prayers up to Craig. As you all know, man, he lost his grandmother recently, passed away. You know what I'm saying? So prayers up to him, his whole family. You know what I'm saying? His grandmother, rest her soul. You know, let's just send some positive vibes, some good energy towards Craig. If y'all got his Instagram, hit him up. You know, if you're a fan of the show and you're a supporter of him, just hit him up, man. So you sending some love, some condolences his way. Pretty sure he needs it right now. And then he'll definitely be back on the show. You know what I mean? As soon as everything works out for him and time permits it. But send some good energy for my guy Craig, man. You know what I'm saying? That's his grandmother. Also JR's, you know, they share a grandmother, they cousin. So, you know, send some love their way, man. Send some love their way.
Nah, for real. And you know, Craig's just one of, like, Craig and the Money, bro, two of my favorite people, just really just genuine souls. And
facts.
Craig just always keep it funky. He can't help it.
He can't help it, man. He just Craig, man. You already know that's Craig Samuels right there, man. He gonna tell it how it is, you know what I'm saying?
I feel like he takes experiences that are potentially really painful and uses them as a catalyst for growth.
Real
and
talk.
That's like something that's just, you can tell through who does, and his character.
Yeah,
like
definitely.
He mans up. I really envy that trait because it's, sometimes for me, like, it's hard, fool. Like, when if something gets me down, like, I'll just, like, dwell in it.
Yeah, dwell in it. Yeah,
and become, like, momentum.
It starts to kind of slow you down in life. It's like, for real. Like, we definitely, man, want to get y'all in the chat, get some more people in here, because we finna have a good discussion. You already know what it is. This big three hip-hop fiasco.
Who's the big three in battle rap?
Okay, I think Jazz asked that question on Twitter, and it was a lot of different options on there. I know a lot of people at the current big three. I've heard a lot of people say me, Nitty, and Twerk.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I've heard people say that me, Nitty, and Twerk was the current big three right now. Like, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Of course, Free to Wave, you know what I'm saying? Surf's always one of those big three type dudes. You know what I'm saying? Like, I would say if it's not me, Nitty, and Twerk in that generation, I would look at it like Surf, Hitman, Tay Rock, or something. You know what I mean?
The big three in hip hop, the reason why they've been that is all those dudes came out
around the same time. Era. That's why I said it has to be an era thing. And Nitty, though he in the era above me and Twerk, he kind of been real dominant in this era. So I think that's why they kind of like throw him in there with us. But it got to be something like that, man. It's got the mixture of those names right there, man. You got the Hitman Holla, of course, for his views and everything he does in these eras, man. Me and the accolades, the bells, Nitty for the change
like
in the game.
Hitman Holla more like in like a Jay-Z, Nas category.
Type of category, you know, that's why I feel like Rock is that same way. And same with like a Surf, you know what I'm saying? They kind of precede this era, you know what I'm saying? They've been around since the Smack was doing one rounders. You know what I'm saying? When Smack would drop the battles round by round.
Right.
So I feel like, if you're talking this generation, this era of like, you got a Geechi Gotti blueprint of rappers who come in the game and they talk gangster shit, street shit, and you got the Rum Nitty, the back-to-back punching people that follow him, then you got the dudes who patting their whole style off of Twerk with the lead up to the big bomb haymakers, to the way he move his hands and everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like, hands down, it got to be us as the big three.
So you think this is basically based on influence is what you're saying? You feel like that? Is that what defines big three?
Yeah, it got to be your influence, skill, you know what I'm saying? Big moments and matchups and battle rap, it had to be like big like moments and matchups because nobody could be over those three because nobody else consistently kind of headlines from that era besides us three. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like you'll see any of us in any given moment being the headline battle. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Just seeing me headlining versus Easy the Block Captain, a headlining versus Mugen, and you see Twerk headlining versus Mugen, and me versus Lux, and you got Nitty versus Lux. All the same. It's like, you know what I mean? It's that same circle of people that's getting those big matchups, and you know what I'm saying?
I'm inclined to agree.
I
think, though, it's kind of weird that it's the same thing that happened in mainstream hip-hop, where those three dudes were so dominant with their influence.
Yeah.
that it was really hard for a new generation
to even kind of, it's like that right now in battle rap.
No Diddy penetrate.
I know exactly what you're saying, to like breaking through, the breakthrough.
Yeah.
But in battle rap, I feel like the difference with the industry is, you know what I'm saying? Like you can still battle for that spot. Like if somebody is on the come up and they have a good year, then eventually they can be like, all right, I gotta see Twerk, I gotta see Nick, I gotta see Gotti, and people be like, yo, is this for the generation? You know what I'm saying? Like you've seen that when Easy was getting hot,
he
gotta battle Gotti to see, and I had to fight for my spot. You know what I mean? Smacking back down, let him know like, ain't your time yet, young buck. I'm still hot right now.
I'm pretty sure he's older than you.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. He definitely. So other than, you know what I'm saying, but when Twerk, when we both battled, you know what I mean, the first Caffeine event, that was like the king of the era type of battle. So we still battle for those positions. Like I think in industry it's kind of tougher until they go at each other. Mm-hmm. Like right now what we seeing, you know what I'm saying, like the debate is always who's the best. Now it's like, hold on, they finna go at it. Now we finally can kind of gauge it a little bit, you know, because you can't gauge in no other way besides numbers in the industry. And honestly, if we can go down the list, J. Cole nor Kendrick numbers are matching Drake's.
No. You know what I'm saying? Like Drake is literally in the conversation with Michael Jackson.
Yeah, when it comes to the numbers, you know what
you
I'm saying?
You can only compare Drake in this era to Taylor Swift and Bad Bunny.
Shit like that, you know what I'm saying?
You feel like, me? Like he's not, I mean? He is in his own galaxy.
But now that the diss is out, first, people were saying AI. I think Drake has kind of alluded to the fact that, hey, he ain't came out and dropped it, but it's like he letting people know, I said the shit about Metro. I obviously said it about Ross. He going back and forth with Ross online. He been trolling Kendrick. He been trolling Metro.
So basically, that shit is not AI.
We know that's a real diss. Everybody knows it's a real one. But since that diss, Kendrick has had disses dropping. It's been AI.
Which were fire, too. And like the Kendrick, yeah. I heard a Kendrick AI diss where I was like, I wish he really did that. Like,
but I don't, this is the sad thing about the world. It's like now we can literally have AI disses.
Yeah.
But I'm on some like, and this ain't saying Kendrick did this, but now I'm thinking like, if somebody diss track don't get received well, they can just be like, oh, that was AI. That wasn't me. Like the moment, you know what I'm saying? The moment everybody like, oh, that one wasn't it. Oh, yeah, that was AI. You know what I'm saying? Now they just leaking them on the low and barely just letting the crack. Because I think even with Drake, it was like when he dropped it, first people was like trying to hate on it, and then after they really listen, everybody like, nah, I ain't gonna lie, Drake is wildin'. You know what I'm saying? That very first initial Drake drop, people was like, man, this ain't it. So they like, it's AI. But then once everybody said it was good, even Drake was like, hell yeah, drop it, give me 50, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Like, told y'all this was the one, you know what I'm saying?
But it was really Frack.
Yeah, exactly. Like
Frack with AI.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, what the
fuck?
Doing
it for my Jewish brother Drake, you feel me?
Man. So it's like, how do you feel, man, right now? Cause a lot of people is saying this, and it's like Kendrick, they saying he on the clock, man. Like people is on some, they like, man, what's taking him so long? Like he what's going on? Ross responded already.
Here's the thing, right? Look, off rip, Drake, the first version that we heard, this how I know it wasn't AI. Yeah. It had a different beat. It had the Get Money sample at first. It's funny. And then there was one I heard, it had the What's Beef.
Yeah, you feel me? Like, different again.
Like, so it was like, okay, they're like, you could hear the evolution of the beat going. And then like,
really got to.
And then the final version, like, to be honest with you, I hadn't even heard the real version of it when I spoke on it last time when I was on No Jumper.
Yeah.
Like now after really like looking back at the playback footage and all that.
Like now I really done listen to it.
Man, Drake did the damn thing he really, really did, fool.
And if y'all in the chat haven't heard it, we want to play it for y'all. You know what I mean? The page shouldn't get...
Chat, okay, let's get it. The performance game and found you at the end of the night.
Oh, man, salute, man. Was that my guy Westside J? Yep. Okay, man, definitely, man. You know what, man? I know you couldn't find me, man, but you know it's all love. I think I probably got up out of there at the end of the night, man. I was so tired, I ain't gonna lie.
Cracking, there's hella people there.
Yeah, I was so tired, man. We were standing up. It was hot in there. It was a good event, though. Like, salute Calico, Black Mafia Battle League. Shout out my opponent, Joey Linwood. Hope to see him continue to grow, get bigger opportunities. You know what I mean? Growing this game of battle rap. He's an up-and-comer doing his thing. That's who I battled. And then the rest of the car was dope, man. Shout out to the ladies. I see and Yoshi did it up. Lady Caution and what's that?
New Boobs Yoshi's yeah, going baby. Crazy.
Yeah, I'm saying. Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. New Boobs Yoshi. Yeah. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yoshi G.
Yoshi,
you know
Yoshi D.
You know what I'm saying? So, salute to them, Cal and Reed, with the main event. Salute to the whole Landslide Camp. Them my brothers right there. They always show love, man. You know
Black
what I mean?
Mafia Blackface. Battle League is an amazing name.
Crazy, right? Yeah, event. Come on.
It's such a, yo, Detroit is the one of the most fire cities. No, I don't facts. Get people don't like they're terrified nah, to be Detroit there and
love,
shit. But
I love it.
I love Detroit love it, so man. Fucking
nah,
much.
For real. And I gotta give Calico his flowers. That building was wrapped, was packed. Man, he had 1,000 people in there,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, look cracking.
Yeah,
bro.
He had 1,000 folks in there, man, that came out to support him. That lets you know the support you got in your city. You know what I'm saying? Like, 1,000 folks
no,
showed
no
up.
Violence, no bullshit.
Violence, no bullshit.
That's hard to pull off out
no,
there.
No, man, no violence, no bullshit. It was good energy. The battles was good. It was. I mean, the time was running good, too, though. You know, from, of course, events like that is always going to run a little later and start a little later. You know what right. I'm saying? We on real nigga time, like Smack say. But for the most part, all the battles were still being able to go back to back. People wasn't getting too tired, you know what I'm saying, in there. And it was a good event, man. So, yeah, salute to him, man. For real, for real. Definitely want to see more Black Mafia Battle League battles, man.
I would love to go out and fuck with that.
Yeah.
We was there a few years ago for the King of the Dot thing. And, it was me, Avo, and this fool Clayton. And we were all through downtown Detroit on 4th of July. It was cracking as fuck.
Yeah.
Like, there's so everybody just pulling up in their whips. Like, the whole city converged there. And, like, everyone, I was like, bro, this is lit. It's like Oakland energy.
We did an episode, man. It's going to be coming out soon. My very first full review and episode. You know what we going to call it, what the show going to be called. Maybe some more snack guy type shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But Avo filmed it. My cousin, DJ Just 100. Was there and he took us to a pizza spot because you know they known for their Detroit square pizzas.
That's,
so we went to
with,
Buddies. We went to Buddies. If you're from Detroit, that's where we went. Went to Buddies, man.
One of the famous ones too.
I was gonna ask. Do you remember the name of the joint
yeah,
that we were
I was talking to him about it. I forget.
It was fire.
It was fire though. Yeah, it was fire, man. So we went to Buddies. I did have a Coney. We didn't film that, but I did. I had a Coney. Man,
I fucks with. We had a Coney too.
I had a Coney,
bro. We first of all. King of the Dot, bro. God bless my brothers, right? I love King of the Dot, right? They had us in the, because like they didn't know, right?
Yeah, they just had to put a room anywhere, right?
They had us in the fucking jankiest. We were in the trenches, fool. It was like 8 Mile and Indiana, I think. So from Detroit, you'll know. Yeah. And like, it gets way trenchier in Detroit for sure. But it was.
It was still,
we're pulling up to the motel with that. Now, you know, shouts to King of the Dot. They wound up extracting us and putting us somewhere else. Yeah, we had all this camera equipment. Yeah. There's fucking, I'm like, bro, we about to get fucking lined up, fool. Straight up. Yeah, we were a lick, bro. I
like, who's these white boys that just pulled up with all this shit? Ugh.
Bro, it smelled like, I know what it smelled like. Yeah, it smelled like crack in the elevator, bro.
Yeah, for
like,
sure. It was there, for sure.
Guess who's Bizax too? Yeah, smelled crack in this elevator.
Snowman was in the building.
There's a lot going on. And then me, and I was like, bro, we got to go to Coney, dog. Fool. Yeah. Like, we got to go to the Coney.
Got
to
get some Coney.
I'm like a Detroit aficionado. Sure. That's one of them places.
Gotta love it.
You feel me? Like buffs. You feel
yeah,
me?
Yeah, come on.
Like everything.
I need me a pair of buffs, man. Next time I go back, I'm getting some buffs.
Yeah.
Man.
If you could wear buffs in a hood situation in Detroit
and not
get them yanked off your face, you're a joint.
Come on, man. Gotta give me some buffs. Man.
That's a big thing.
You know what I'm saying? Cartier frames for
no,
man.
No party Cartiers either.
Nah,
real buffalo horns.
Real buffs, man. You know what I'm saying? I told my opponent, man, he rocking fake buffs. Call them steroids, man. You know what I'm saying?
That's fire.
Steroids, man. Detroit, y'all can have that, man. Anybody got fake buffs, man? They steroids, man.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? No party Cartiers.
You feel me?
Buffs and wires. For
real.
But like, we walked hella far, fool. It was like a damn near 2 miles, right? Yeah, and they don't really walk out there like
that.
Yeah,
for real.
Like,
yeah, it'd be cold as fuck out there to be
it's
walking.
It's the Motor City. You be mopping. So
yeah, for sure.
It was in the summer, so it wasn't cold. Okay. But still, like, fools don't be like.
Yeah.
We didn't see a single other
Everybody
pedestrian.
Got whips, man. You know
everybody got
yeah,
whips.
Everybody whipping.
So we walk. We go to the Coney, you feel me? You know, Avo, healthy ass, ain't trying, but he got this motherfucker eating the Coney.
Yeah, straight up. Yeah, you know, just for the ambiance.
Now,
When in Rome, do as the Romans.
You feel me? Exactly. Yeah. When in Rome. Yeah. Now, I get it, though. You feel me? Like, not doing that on cam, because the only appropriate way to eat a glizzy on cam is with a fork and knife. You
man,
feel me?
Facts.
Or else sure. You're gay.
Yeah, for sure. On camera, you got the only appropriate way is throw it. I don't know. But it's so crazy. I don't know. I mean, the world made it pause, but like in reality, like, that's like that's what's like... family reunion, cookout, yeah. Barbecue food. Everybody, like, it's nowhere. Like, man, listen, bro. Miracle Market in the hood got, and I can say it freely because it's
the wieners. They got the wieners.
Best chicken links, bro.
Oh, okay.
Chicken links, bro. Like, you get these, you get that on some bread, man. You don't need nothing. You eat that. You know what I mean? Paul's raw. You know what I'm saying? Nothing on it. You
really?
Know what I'm saying? Chicken links fire. Miracle Market really? In Compton, man. Wilmington in the laundry, man.
Okay.
Trust me, man. I ain't lying to you. It stink like a motherfucker in there. When you walk in, it stink like a motherfucker. But the chicken and the ribs, everything is good. I mean, hog head cheese.
We're going, bro.
Yeah, I got you. I need
that.
That's
in
an
my
episode
life.
Right there. I'll take y'all into this stanky ass Miracle Market.
No, I need that.
Get some hog head cheese and crackers, man. And
how much knock does that back. Like going to that speezy right there, how yeah. much would my Compton credibility rise?
Oh, you going up for sure. Yeah, you going up, man. Yeah, you going up. They go, you went to Miracle Market? Yeah. Oh, yeah, man, for sure, man. That's a dangerous market right there, man.
It's like, is that like similar to going to Hawkins and Watts?
For sure. Anybody can't just go to Miracle Market.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Everybody can't just go there. But at the same time, though, I will say, It's a staple. Like, a lot of people know about it. People that, you know, you do barbecues and stuff. Like, that's one of the places in the city where somebody going to go and get all they, like, you know.
When
I
interviewed you on my pod, like, someone was like, asking about Miracle Market.
They're yeah,
like,
they said that. Yeah,
they were
remember?
Talking about all the different mm-hmm. little specific to your
spot
section.
In that area.
You know what I'm
exactly.
saying?
Like, that's right there in the Compton Airport where we did the battles. That Miracle Market is, like, across the street and down a little bit.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, no, that's... That's necessary. But no, nah, shouts to Detroit.
Shouts out to Detroit.
Oh, yeah. But also, where we did the battles at, we was in West Detroit off Finkel.
That was West, okay.
Yeah, that's West
you
Detroit.
You were asking me what area that was, and I remember...
Finkel Road.
It was like, that's a horrible area.
Yeah, yeah. It's and by the way, like, the east side is... That's like the trenchiest part of... Detroit, but like the west side still has the sections and where, and I walked like 3.5 miles through that motherfucker, just like, I don't know, what did I want? I wanted cigarettes and Faygo or some shit. And
yeah.
Like, literally, you got to get the Faygo in Detroit.
You do?
Like, oh, yeah, that's a man.
Or you got to get that Verner's.
Yep.
Verner's ginger ale, man. That's the best ginger ale I ever had. Tastes like real. I don't know what it tastes like.
Yeah.
But I want one right now. That's how good it was.
It tastes healthier than
regular.
It
tastes something. Yeah, it just, it don't taste like, other ginger ale tastes like you sick and you got to drink mm-hmm. it to make you feel better. Mm-hmm. Like, you only drinking a ginger ale out here if you got a cold or you know what I mean? You finna pass out or something. It's like, yo, get him a ginger ale. He finna die.
That's
you
like what I'm saying. That's where my mind's from, my granny drinking like ginger ale with scotch.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But out there, that ginger ale, that Verner's was something different. Shout out Detroit. But for the people in the chat, if y'all haven't heard the diss, I see y'all in there arguing that Kendrick needs to drop today. Drake going crazy. Drake wasn't good enough. All the different shit. We going to play Drake's diss. We going to play some joints for y'all.
D'Angelo, Big Geechi, this is for you. Keep doing your thing.
Okay.
I'm going to get some merch from you soon.
Oh, yeah.
Don't get those donations up. Don't. Well, triple 100, but that's $100 you donated.
Oh, what? Shit, man. Damn,
let's
man.
Go.
Shout out to D'Angelo, man. You know what, man? Appreciate you. You know what I'm saying? First and foremost, man, D'Angelo, you always in here. That's why I do want to. You always in here, man. You always in this joint, man. You always showing love.
You're my favorite R&B singer.
Man. Yeah, you always in here showing love. You show up to every show, man. You in the comments, man. Appreciate that $100 donation. Thank you, man. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, the new merch, I think I said it on Royal Day, but I do got some cloudy gray and black. This is my new color, cloudy gray, man.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying? Cloudy gray and black. Every effing bar. Y'all remember I used to say members only. I switched it up because a lot of people wanted to, you know, to know what the EFB stood for, the people who didn't know. So I put the every effing bar for those, you know. So we got the every effing bar version, cloudy gray and black. DM me, get at me, Cash App, Zelle. You know how we do it. And we ship it right out.
Hey, is that a gang, though? Hey, yeah, what's that
man?
Mean?
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, if you're like, man, members only, EFB, like, man, every fucking bar, man. You know what I'm saying? For the people that don't know.
It is kind of bagged out if you think about it.
Yeah, you just see big ass EFB on somebody. You know what I'm saying? Every fucking blood. You know what I'm saying?
If it shows, there's for sure sounds like a fucking West LA tagger crew.
Something. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, dudes from EFB, dog. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
I'm not going to lie to you. Like, for sure, man. Salute D'Angelo, man. We appreciate it.
Every felony's brutal, dog.
Yeah, exactly. You know what I'm saying? Shit, man. But yeah, let's give them that, man. Let's give them that record. Let's see. Let's see how. What Drake was talking about.
I want people to pay attention to the very, before we started, the very first part of the record. You hear the DJ Who Kid drop.
Who
to
Kid.
Me, it makes it so iconic.
Come on.
And it's, I think it's like Drake alluding to the fact he feel like 50 right now.
Yeah, come on. That's that Who Kid.
He against everybody. And it's a throwback to that era. Now, I think a lot of us are spoiled that grew up in that Beans versus Jada, you feel me? 50 versus Jada. Yeah,
they, want
like,
that, they want that. They want that real raw aggression beef.
Yeah,
these dudes swag. No, Drake got a different style of diss records. Y'all heard the back to back. His style is different on it.
It's more like a Jay-Z type.
Yeah, yeah.
He's in like the it's like a Jay-Z, but like
I'm popping my shit on you, kind
right,
of, you
right, like with a little bit of. I think he took a page out of the West Coast book.
Yeah,
and this is always what I say: nobody makes better diss tracks
than the West, man.
Than West Coast rappers, fool. Like, because fools like, and that's what I want.
That's why Kendrick is on the clock.
Bro.
That's why he on the clock, because come on, bro. Nobody, I mean, it's the West, man. We don't let nobody get at us.
But
you know
I want to see Kendrick do. I want Kendrick to simplify his shit, dumb it down. And do a DJ Quick dollars and cents. I want him to just call him a bitch. I want him to just go super, like, you feel me? Like, he need that. Like, and that little brown bucket pulled up on your side. You feel me? Like, I want Dre Day. You feel me? Easy E can need a big fat dick. Rain can need a fat dick. No, RIP to Easy. I'm not saying that, but you feel me?
Easy.
Yeah, like Compton City G's. Speaking of Easy, I want that energy.
Yeah, definitely. That's what we need, K-Dot. Come on, man.
In fact, put
a Jerry curl in, man.
Do like Pac did and spit a verse and be like, you know, y'all ain't even on my level. I'm gonna let my little homies ride on you, bitch made ass.
Come on,
you feel me? Like,
man, that's how you could do. And then, Pac like one of the realest ones to do that, because a lot of people don't do that on them diss records. You know what I'm saying?
That was the biggest.
Get out the way, yo! Get out the way, yo!
Biggie Smalls just got dropped.
No, ooh, Pastor Mac. And let me hit him in his back. Frank White need to get spanked, right?
That's over. Hit him up. This Drake. Did you hear that? Over
it, hit him up. Oh no, I
didn't.
I
didn't.
No.
So you were saying earlier that they originally used Hit Him Up for this beat.
Like, really?
Sampled it, the tempo. Yeah.
Damn.
Okay, because that's funny, because I heard a Get Money version of it.
They couldn't clear the sample or something. That's why when they.
Oh, because it's the same sample as Get. That's what it was supposed to be.
Yeah.
Now that makes a lot more sense. Okay.
Lines up perfectly.
No, because remember. Remember, that's what
Hit Him Up was.
Hit Him Up was a response to Get. Is like the beat was a response to the Get Money beat or whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, damn, Avo, why you got to add a crease to my cranium like
come
that?
Come on, man. Avo with the hip-hop knowledge that Lush did, man.
Okay, maybe I'm...
You know what I'm saying?
Yo, I think Adam hired the wrong dude.
You know
you got to get a colder white boy on your team.
All right, you guys want to get into this?
Who cares?
It's all the shit like Maroon 5 need a verse, you better do that. Swifties need one, you knew that. Nigga, we better do that. You better do that show in the city. You know what I'm saying? We need you to pull up in the city.
Right.
You know what I mean? We need the young. You got to.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. All right, we drop it, give me 50. It's basically, he kind of talking to him in the sense of like, yeah, man. Like, man, they got you. You know what I'm saying? They need whatever.
You think he said Biddy due to Kendrick's affiliation?
For sure. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. That's another little subtle slick. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, yeah, that's what the people around you, that's what they calling it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You better do that show inside the, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, come on, man.
It's like taunting him.
He taunted him a little bit, yeah.
Pipsqueak is crazy.
Yeah, come on.
He's talking crazy right now.
He's talking crazy, man.
He really is.
He's talking crazy, man. You come on, man. West up, man. What's going
and
on?
I don't want to hear Kendrick get mad.
Nah.
I don't want to hear aggressive yelling.
Get on there and talk crazy back.
No, he
talk your shit back.
Clown,
yeah, you
funny,
got to,
fool,
yeah, you
like,
got to come back with your,
yeah.
You, right now, you got to come back with the same sauce, but just with your Kendrick on it. You know what I'm saying?
And let J Rock get some shit off on that motherfucker
come on.
You feel me?
He supposed to come back and be like, J Prince said you better.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Birdman said you better.
Yeah.
Whatever. Lil Wayne said you better. Like, you know what I'm saying? You got to.
Which low key. Ross already did.
Yeah.
Ross low key.
Yo, Ross.
Rick Ross has entered the chat.
Yeah, no disrespect, Rick Ross, man. Come on, get out the way, boy. Get out the way, man. I love the beat you picked. I love the shit you was saying after the shit. It's dope, but like you way, it was your time for beefing with Drake. It's another time. It's this Kendrick and Drake right now. This is the heavyweight matchup for this era. You lost to 50 already, man.
He got obliterated.
So it's like you can't try to come back and get this one. Like, it's dope that you drop soon as somebody mentioned he mentioned you and said something. But like, we ain't even expecting Drake to get back on you. We need Drake and Kendrick, man.
Drake is a straight psyop.
Yeah, it's Drake and Kendrick right now, man.
What I want to know is,
it's the beef. It's the one we want.
Here's my left field conspiracy theory. All right.
Okay.
Sales are down in hip hop.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? What if everyone just got together and were like, we're going to do a little rap game stimulus pack.
Ooh.
And we all just finna beef with each other.
We gotta go at Drake real quick.
Let's get it hot. Shit entertaining again.
Because
it works.
Oh, it's working.
And everybody eating.
They all need to drop an album then.
You feel me?
Albums got to drop around this shit.
Like something.
If it's going to work, you know what I'm saying? Albums got to drop. Metro and them eating right now. Everybody buying that Future.
That shit.
Metro album. That shit out of here.
And Kendrick.
J. Cole album doing crazy. We even got Daylight Nab Soul in the top 100 with that record.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? On the record with him.
Which is real as fuck of Cole. Except for, you know what? J. Cole.
You're a pussy, bro.
You're a fucking... You have
and that's no disrespect in as your manhood, but in rap terms, you a sucker, man. You took the beat, took it back, man.
You let Nas down.
Yeah.
You let me down.
You can't do that, Cole.
You let Levi down.
I fucks with Cole. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, I think Cole got bored.
I love Cole.
Yeah,
and
I think Cole got bored. And his diss was fire.
It was fire. I went through this period of my life where I was like heavily induced. I was on a lot of drugs. And that was kind of when that's when he dropped like Forest Hill Drive and all that. Before that, like I was a J. Cole mixtape fan and like early Rock Nation J. Cole. I was a fan of that.
Mm-hmm.
Then I was like, you know, this fucking college kid fucking crying about his tuition is boring.
Come on.
I don't give a fuck about this lame, you feel me? Oh, the neighbors think I'm selling dope. No, they don't, fool.
They don't.
The neighbors think you're fucking playing basketball,
come on, and
what you are in your backyard.
Yeah.
Like, come on, fool. Like, you're a dork. So I had all these thoughts about him, and it didn't matter how good he rapped.
Yeah, I didn't want to hear it.
I was just like, you're a fag.
Yeah, yeah, straight drop though.
Like, you suck.
No, that's really what it was. And then looking at now come full circle, years later, you drop a hot diss record in the moment of the time. This is the thing about J. Cole that where he let hip-hop down at, and I'm going to let him, and he got to hear this, you know what I'm saying, from one MC to another, bro. This is the spirit of hip-hop. All you guys was talking about, y'all the best. This is that energy. This that genre. Nobody's expecting y'all to see each other. We're not expecting J. Cole and Kendrick to meet up and throw hands. Nobody saw that.
No.
Nobody thought that. Nobody was expecting that. This wasn't Biggie and Pac's, like, rest their souls, but nobody was thinking that. If we thought that, we'd have been like, nah, I was glad he took that down.
Right.
Before some shit got out of hand. This was all bars to us. Yo,
and it's not no drill music shit.
This ain't no, this is all of y'all. We're not looking at none of the three as if, we're not saying y'all not capable and that y'all don't got people with y'all that's capable. But we looking at all three of y'all as top artists that's really just on some hip hop, really trying to be the best rapper who got the crown type of beef. So when you drop yours and you taking it back, it's like, do you want the crown or what? Do you want to be that guy or what?
You've said meaner shit in battles to me, man. And you weren't even battling me.
That's a fact. And
that, like, and I didn't even.
I'm about to drop a J. Cole diss record next.
Please, you deserve it, bro. Yeah, I'm everyone should just fucking lyrically run.
Everybody bomb. Everybody bomb on J. Cole. Yeah. Make him fight back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like that for real needs to be the move. He has and I like Drake addresses it in this record. We'll get into that in a sec.
I don't give a fuck what Cole say.
Cole, you know what I'm saying? And it's funny because he won me back over with that fucking L.A. Leakers freestyle. That verse on Bia's shit. That Johnny P's Caddy verse is one of the best verses.
J. Cole got the raps. He got them.
He do.
And the 7-minute drill was fire, bro, but you took it back, so.
And it's also weird because the whole album is compromised to me now, you know?
Yeah, it's tough.
Because, like, on every single song, he's making little, feel me? Like, if it ain't directed, it ain't respected. But if you look at hip-hop history, people used to like, and I'm talking going back to like the early 90s, the East Coast fools wouldn't diss each other directly like that. Yes, there were certain examples like KRS-One and MC Sham going at it, and there were things, but a lot of fools were doing subliminal disses.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's why that's why Q-Tip says on this scenario, I could give a damn about an ill subliminal, because that was like what they called the ill subliminals. Mm-hmm. It was like people were celebrating. Like, I think at the time, Tribe and Beat Nuts were like going back and like, there was different little fools dissing each other and shit, but it wasn't like...
It wasn't like, nobody saying nobody's name. Yeah.
Right. It wasn't. So, like, I respect the art of doing that, but when you build it up to this, like, climactic moment...
This was the moment.
And then, like...
It's 2024, man.
This fool neutered himself.
This was the year for y'all to, like, we was finna argue it right now. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, even people would have been arguing, was Drake's diss better than J. Cole's?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Even though they both was going at the same person, it would have been like, I don't know, J. Cole went harder, Drake went harder. Like, come on, man. We was expecting y'all to jump on there like the Avengers and go against everybody together real quick.
Right.
Drake got like a 20-verse-1 going on right now. You know what I'm saying? Everybody going at him. But yeah, man, J. Cole, man. You let us down, bro.
J. Cole, we're changing your name to J. Cat.
J. Cat. It's hot.
Okay.
Wow. Hi.
Okay. Does Pusha T got the long coke dealer nails? That you, that's like, I mean, you, bro, how many like pin? Somebody, like
they gotta be trolling. I mean, if they not, then they not. But you know what I'm saying?
I've seen Drake with his nails painted.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Like, I'm thinking he's just being funny on like a play on that. But
you ain't never got a manicure before, Geechi?
Nah, I don't. I get pedicures though. Like I go, in there. You know what I'm saying? I let them keep the feet clean. I don't do no clear coat, none of that shit. They just get them right. But when it comes to the hands, I do see dudes who do it. So I ain't judging them. But me, I grab it, the clipper, and keep my.
If my money was up, I'm getting all that.
Yeah,
shit.
I just go in there. You know, let them get the feet clean, Maylene.
Yeah, she
get me right. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna lie. You know what I'm saying?
Young be doing.
She gets you all the way right. It's just I ain't never sat. This just me personally. Like I say, the fellas who is doing it, I'm not knocking y'all, man. You know what I'm saying? Geechi just, you know, I'm just, man, just get my feet right, man. I'm gonna grab a clipper myself and go do 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 do. You know what I'm saying? Soap and water. You know what I'm saying? Keep the nails fresh. I don't like no dirty nails though.
What you know what I'm saying?
I don't want dirty nails and shit. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
That's not P. What would you, bro? Okay, Geechi.
Okay.
You get a call from Drake.
Okay.
And he's like, I'm taking down south like Ludacris.
Yeah.
Even Geechi Gotti said, and then you come on, use a bitch. Would you do that on a Kendrick diss track being from the city?
For sure. Drizzy, hit me up, boy. We got one. Yeah. I'm doing that motherfucking we dissing nigga about motherfucking pops. You know what I'm saying? Drizzy, what's happening, man? We going viral, man.
That would be, bro.
You know what I'm saying? That'll be big, but
make it happen. Because
it's still in the honor of hip hop, man. Like, I ain't got no beef with no Kendricks and I ain't got no beef with no Drake. So, you know what I'm saying? If he called me in and you know what I'm saying? Hey, Kendrick, call me up. You want me to say it?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
It's not personal.
It's hip hop, man. You know what I'm saying? So I think I would love to see them like use like other little, you know, little things like that. Like I think when Drake even did the AR app shout
that's
out.
That's what I was about to say.
You know
say.
What I'm saying? Like that was big for Philly.
That
was big for that situation, knowing AR app, one of the big top goons in Philly at the time, having this situation going on. So it's like, even though he dissing Meek Mill, it's like, I'm going to throw shots to somebody else from your city that niggas respect and fuck with.
Well,
so
I think that's dope. And Meek wasn't fucking with each other. Yeah,
so it was dope. Beef, you know what I mean? So I like when rappers do that shit. So yeah, man, tap in, man. I hit him with that user bitch. You know what I'm saying? $5 million.
$5 million.
$1 million for that user bitch. You did right on.
If I had to go. And funny, dude.
Just yeah, like, facts though.
We throw Rick Cuffer like I'm Ricky.
Cuffer
bro.
Like I'm Ricky. Come on, man. And which y'all is right in the chat. I did diss the game before, so
yeah, that's yeah, how so I
don't really
first
got.
Heard,
I don't really got no picks when it comes to the city, man.
The
I'm at
first
y'all.
Time I heard Geechi Gotti rap, it was the game diss
and it
track.
Wasn't personal then. I always tell this story. My homeboy, man. He hit me up. When he was out at the time when this went down, he was a huge Meek Mill fan. Like, he just thought Meek Mill was one of the top rappers, you know?
He was.
And I think Game and Meek had, like, a beef going on.
They did.
And I remember we was in the hood. He was like, man, somebody need to diss Game, man. I'm tired of, you know what I'm saying? He's like, man, you should just diss him, like, on some Compton shit, man. You feel me? Meek, he say some shit, same type of shit. Like, Meek, fuck around here, you diss that nigga, want to come to the hood or something. Like, we just diss Game. I'm like, fuck it, I'm right here. We going to the studio that day. I'm like, fuck it, I'll diss him on the hood. And just dissed him, like, you know what I'm saying, on the real. So, I mean, that basically was just also like the homie, like, saying, like, man, fuck Game, man, we rocking with Meek. And that was just my personal partner who really felt that way, you know what I'm saying? So,
that's
yeah.
funny as fuck that you literally did that because your homie, like,
on the real.
Fuck it, I'm just, when we gonna
on
go
real.
In,
on the real,
you
man.
Got nothing to lose at that point. You're not, like, you feel me, like a famous rapper yet. You probably didn't even know it get as much motion
I ain't
as
know
did.
It was gonna get the motion. It got so much motion. Shout out my homie Ace Noodles that's in the pen, man. He called me. That's my older homie. You know what I'm saying? He called me, was like, man, after so long, he like, man, because I shot a video for it and everything. He was like, nah, don't put that video out. Eventually, like, take that down. You know what I'm saying? You done already smoked niggas, did all this shit. They going to try to blackball you, hate you out the, like, your relationships and shit like that. Like, man, don't even let that
and
keep going.
And it could become, like, some gang shit type.
He wasn't even tripping off the gang shit. He was just more so on the industry side of it. Like, him having more...
connections right. and friendships. They're probably looking at it like, damn, man, it's another little dude from Compton coming up, going crazy. Like, don't do no songs with him or whatever. He like just on some business shit. Like, man, don't even
which
don't
probably feed into did
it.
Happen.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm saying. He like don't even feed into it. You ain't got to do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you already hot. So, man, shout out to my bro for doing that, calling me from the four yard with that advice. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Big Dog. But like, I gotta be honest. Game is one of the most skillful diss track creators
straight up
in hip hop history.
And he never said nothing back. That game diss, I should have re-uploaded because that shit was motherfucking.
You took it down?
I took it down. Okay, I didn't probably delete it, but I probably archived
the audio.
I put it back up there probably because I need to show them how to do diss records. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah, man. They forgot Geech's one of them, man. Yeah, yeah. I dissed him. Yeah, yeah, yeah. He ain't say nothing.
It's super funny because like. Game versus Joe Budden, Game, all that old shit, bro. Yeah. Like, he was fucking.
But I wasn't as big as I am now either that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's why, though, it did, like, it probably had like 20,000 views or some shit like that. But nobody really knew who I was. Like, I just barely was scratching the surface with the battle rap shit. You know what I'm saying? So, had that dish probably came out now, that shit probably would be more like, oh, news. Like, what the fuck? Like,
that was before you had ever been on URL.
I wasn't on that or nothing yet. Yeah, on the real. It was just, you know, I was still on the come up. So, yeah, definitely, man. It's a different time, man.
But yeah.
Yeah, that whole last little sequence is crazy.
It is.
Numbers wise, I'm out of here. You're not fucking keeping up. You know what I'm saying? Money wise, I'm out of here. You're not fucking creeping up. That little show money you get, that's merch money feed us. Like, he really just get the pop. That's that popping your shit type of shit. That you can say it's like that's levels. Like, I can't talk that shit. Kendrick, Drake, J. Cole, all richer than me.
Of course.
But in their perspective lanes, for you to be able to talk to somebody else like that is still that's big in the rap gang. Like, man, what, man, that little show money, that's merch money feed us.
Right.
We making that off selling these Drake tees. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, we getting all that. They giving you what, 100 a show, man? We make 100 after we sell out these OVO shutters. You know what I mean?
I literally saw Drake get paid over 100 stacks for a show in front of my own face.
Come on.
In 2014.
Come on.
And I'm backstage, fool. And like, I was like, I don't know if I was on an ecstasy. I was on some shit. And like, I'm with Organic and them, you feel me? So we with Drake. We like backstage.
Yeah,
and shit.
For sure.
All of a sudden, I'm like, damn, I'm too high. I need to like sit down. I'm like 10 feet away from this Louis bag,
man,
that has over 100 bands in it.
They dropped it on him.
I'm just like,
we locking you in, Drake, for whatever date. We just know you finna make it back for us.
I think it was his payment for the show he just did.
Yeah, come on.
I think it was like that. Like, that's how he got paid.
We just sold out. Air Canada Center.
Like the Louis, you know what I'm saying? The Louis bag was. It was a Hollywood Bowl.
Come on.
The Louis bag was probably like 15 racks itself.
Come on.
But then,
man,
I seen him.
Take the bag and the money, man.
Yeah.
Keep the bag too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's what I'm saying. Like, so he popped.
That was then. That's a decade ago, man.
He popping his shit still. He going crazy. K-Dot, you got to come back off of this.
Yeah.
A motherfucker tell you that little show money, man, that's merch money feed us. You got to come back on that one.
Especially
like,
when
you going to see
really
how much merch money you make with your face on a shirt, motherfucker.
Now tell me.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to come back hard, man. Come on, K-Dot. You got to.
Tell me I'm tripping, bro, or do I feel like the whole thing between Kendrick and Drake has really been Kendrick getting at Drake for a while. And I don't know specifically. I know, like, my boy What's the Dirt did a whole video dissecting it. Shout out to him. Great channel on YouTube. But, like, it always seemed like it's Kendrick getting that Drake on wax. Yeah. Kendrick in the BET cipher that put a sensitive rapper back in his pajama clothes.
Yeah, for real.
Yeah, you know, like
he been going at him for a long time. I see the comments in there. Yeah, man. I switched sides on the game. Geechi defended the game with Pat. No, man, I always wanted to clear that up too. I didn't defend the game. For a lot of people didn't know, man, we were in talks, me and Pat, for battling. So when he did the game diss, that was just me throwing the bait out there to keep the talks going. URL had reached out to us to try to do a Summer Madness. I think one of the events Pat wasn't available for, so we were supposed to do it right after that. And then he ended up,
I think,
course,
wasn't y'all
away.
Booked on King of the
we
Dot?
We was booked on King of the Dot before to do something. And I think it just was timing and that COVID happened on both.
Yeah, that's
things.
What it was. Y'all you got booked saying? To battle right before COVID.
And so you know that was that. But I wasn't taking up for no game. What? Diss him again. You
right.
Know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? RP Pat.
And I think Game Low Key cleared that up.
Yeah, definitely. Like, yeah. No, they cleared that up and had that going on. You know what I'm saying?
And salute Pat, God rest his soul. He was just, that was like a left field shot.
Yeah, yeah.
Like,
his record was crazy though.
It was a dope ass record.
He was fucking with
dope ass record and like really great production.
CG said Kendrick is taking too long for my liking. Rakeem Carr said Kendrick has been chasing him for a minute. So I mean, I guess they're in agreement with you when saying Kendrick was taking those shots. So this is where it comes down to us saying Kendrick is on the clock. This is what we saying he on the clock. And I'm a fan of hip hop. I'm a fan of being fair. All the shits, but. You have been throwing the subtle shots. People have been saying Drake wasn't fighting back or he been letting you take the shots for a minute. But he finally drops and he drops a whole record. He's saying a lot of personal shit. Hey, man, you're talking about your splits that you're doing with your album, saying what you got to do, saying you're getting extorted. He's saying a lot of he took the gloves off. This ain't no light diss, but people saying it's light.
He took the velvet gloves off.
He took the velvet gloves off. He's saying some fly shit. He popping his shit. He getting at your character. He getting at your pockets. It's been a Ross already dropped saying something, whatever. We ain't even acknowledging that because we waiting on yours. I ain't gonna lie, we need something by the weekend, man.
Yeah,
we need something by the weekend because right now it's at its hottest.
Yeah,
like right now it's like you drop something, he gotta come back. You know what I'm saying? Like
right.
we can get like two or three, then y'all can disappear and the beefs can be over with, and y'all can go back and give us about two to argue over. Give us both one each, two each. Let us argue over that, but we can't wait. You can't drop a diss record in August.
Right.
Because it's over, and then Drake could be like, man, what the hell, I already, you know what I'm saying? It's like, the beef is on right now.
Right.
And K-Dot, you from the city, you know how it is when it's on right now. If motherfuckers came through and slid right now, we can't slide back 6 months later talking about, oh, it's, ain't no expiration date, but we up now.
Especially
if we didn't already slid on you come back 6 months later, man, it's like, man, nigga suckers, man.
Right.
Your man's already had a funeral and everything.
Come on.
You know what I'm saying?
You were supposed to shoot that funeral up, yeah. You feel me? Like,
your man's already had a funeral and everything, man. You coming back way later, man, kids in school, all kind of shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We ran through the whole summer, man. You waiting to school back in, man. No, you got to drop now while the beef is hot, while everybody is watching, the lights is on. Like, right now is the, man, you can drop a bomb on it. No matter what you drop, we listening to it.
Gaming 50, we're responding day by day.
You got to do this, man. Kendrick, bro, you got to. Cause it ain't, and then Drake already hinted that it's another one on the last one at the end. It's still like a hint.
I got more.
So it's like you got to. He telling you what's up. Like, nah, man.
If that's his warning shot,
come
like,
on.
You know, like just like he claimed his.
I don't see how you could be in the studio and you ain't recording it.
Yeah.
Me personally.
Yeah.
There's no way you went to the studio
that would be
since
tormenting
then.
Me.
There's nothing else to go to the studio and do. You can't go to the studio and make a record right now.
And I don't want to hear like a peaceful like declaration.
No.
I don't want to hear some poetic ass
shit.
No,
I don't want
you
on another feature giving 16 bars and only giving like six lines to Drake and like and everybody. No, we want a full clip.
I don't want your Eminem impression.
Yeah.
Jumping out of the plane with the course of the tax.
No,
I don't want to hear
minutes,
that,
man.
Kendrick. Like,
come on,
I want,
man. We need a 3-4 minute record, man.
I want. What would MC8 do? What would DJ Quick do?
Woke up quick. At about noon. You need to do that beat and somehow put that underneath some shit.
You need to make that
ain't
song get
something.
Released
come
soon.
On. It need to be something. Ain't no future in your front and something, man.
You feel me? Like, you need to... I want him to keep it gangster. Like, look. Tim Dog back in the day. You know who Tim Dog is? Yeah, of course. He
come
made
on.
That... You know, he made that the album and that
come
song.
On. Come on.
He said, fuck the city. You feel
I know
me?
What you're talking?
Then Rodney Owen and Joe Cooley came back. They said, fuck New York. You feel me?
Come on, man.
I want to hear that energy.
That's like, what we coming like, for, man.
Fuck.
You jumped on that like that, Rodney O and Joe Cooley.
You feel me?
I mean, salute the future. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Shout out Rodney on Joe Cooley.
That
you know
was an everlasting bass flip. Yeah. Yep.
Come on, man. Y'all listen to that Rodney on Joe Cooley Nutty Block.
Come on.
You know what I'm saying? It's a song called Nutty Block by Rodney on Joe Cooley, too, man. You know what I'm saying?
I didn't even know they was from the section like
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
okay?
they out that area, man.
You got BG
saying?
Knockout. You got some. That area's got
a lot of talent. A lot of talent in the city, man.
Tremendous.
But like I'm saying, with this Kendrick, we need you, man. Compton, we ain't standing for it. And I fucks with Drizzy. Drizzy, my God, 100 grand. We ain't even gonna act like I don't rock with the homie. But this about hip hop, man. This ain't about relationships and all that, man. It's hip hop right here. Somebody shot at you, you got to put that work in, man.
And you low-key cast the first
stone. You shot first. You shot deuce, boom, boom. You know what I'm saying? He came back. Yeah, he came back with the Mac 10.
And I like Kendrick's shit, especially the way he ended it. Yeah. Like, Kendrick's shit was cool. It was.
Come on.
It was cool, but that's not what I want to see. Nah. I want your own version of Dollars and Cents.
Come on, man.
I want you to talk about
DJ Quick shit, man.
You don't have to talk about Drake sucking your dick. You feel me?
None
like
of that,
like
man.
DJ Quick did.
Yeah, none of that, man.
But that was
you know what I'm saying?
But none you left that. Out the G because the G ain't in you. You feel me? Like
come on, man.
We need that.
We need that, bro. We
come so on, fire. Man.
Y'all letting him even tease something like that?
What I really want to do is I want to hear Kendrick also do what a great West Coaster would do.
Okay.
And end the track with like a minute and a half of just
shit talking. Yeah, what Ross was doing on his shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You guys want to hear this really fast?
Which one?
On top of this beat?
Okay, yeah.
Let's play it through. We ain't gonna stop it. Yeah, we ain't gonna stop it.
Never be nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for now. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't ever take no chain off of us. How the fuck you bitch stepping with a size 7 man's on? This the part with the bite, nigga, what's up? I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up. Extortion, baby, whole career, you been shook up. This top toe you dropping, give me 50 likes of push-ups.
Crazy, huh? It's very dope, but also I got, first off,
fuck your bitch and the click you clap. It's like you can never.
Nah,
that's the toughest part about that beat because that was actually dope. It was on beat and everything, but you got to start off anytime on that beat. It got first off, fuck your bitch and the click you claim.
Right,
West Side when we ride, come equipped with gang. You claim to be a player, but I fucked your wife. We bust on bad boys, niggas. Fuck for life. Plus, Puffy trying to see me.
Weak hearts are ripped. Pause.
Biggie Smalls and Julia Mafia. Some mark-ass bitches. Come on, man. Like, he ain't even coming with no bars or nothing. Pac just straight on the disrespect out the gate. Like, that shit was different, man. Shout out Biggie. Shout out them. But I ain't going to lie, man. For me, Hit 'Em Up is always, like, top 1, 2 disrespectful diss records of all time,
it's,
man.
It's,
that and No Vaseline is like two of the most disrespectful.
I feel like as much as I love No Vaseline and as much as like, you know, Cube was my hero growing up, I don't think that record has aged very well.
Yeah, not as much as that right there.
No, not like,
you know what I'm saying?
It's been like, dude, like, No Vaseline is about fucking a grown man in the butt.
Yeah, straight up. Yeah, like, no, facts.
It's
though.
A very gay song.
Yeah, it is. Like, that's why I say it's disrespectful to the motherfucker.
It's very disrespectful.
You know what I'm saying? Disrespectful to the motherfucker, but it haven't aged gracefully like Pac did. I think Pac's probably the, besides Real Compton City G's, because Real Compton City G's did age real well. Shout out Eazy-E,
BG Knock
Out Them, and Dre Day. Those all age, but I say Hit 'Em Up is still like,
that's the
GOAT, man, of like going at.
This song?
Yeah, like for me, like, it's very direct.
I'll take it. Like, it's really, like,
it's very direct.
if you listen to Ether, which a lot of people are probably in the chat, like, mm-hmm. oh, Ether, you know, which, but I'm.
Yeah, people like Ether.
Shout I love Miles. Ether. People are going to crucify me for this. I'll say it again. I like Takeover better than Ether.
Well, yeah, Takeover was like, one of those ones, what I'm saying. But I always said that, but I ain't, you know what I mean? I ain't even trying to be on
to
that.
To be
man.
Honest, the hardest diss track from that entire exchange was the Blueprint 2 joint, where he's all like, can't y'all see that he faked the rap version of TD Jakes prophesizing on your CDs and tapes? That whole shit, you feel me? Like,
come on, man.
Is it Uchi Wally Wally or is it one mic? Is it Black Girl Lost or Shorty Owe You for Ice?
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, come on. Like he, that was character assassination in a cold that, like, to me, that is the greatest diss from that entire exchange between Jay and Nas.
What's your favorite diss of all time? Lush.
I'm a huge fan of that that Checkmate, you feel me? That that Jada versus 50. Is it called Checkmate or Piggy Bank? Yeah. I forget. But the one like Snake Ass, use an animal, use a motherfucking animal. That right there, bro, like I love that song. That's a perfect diss track. Mm-hmm. That exchange between Jada and Beanie, that whole thing, game 300 bars is insane. I'm gonna still say probably Hit Him Up, and really like the diss track I listen to the most is definitely Compton City G's. Like the literally like four of the you have to have at least four songs from Compton in the top 10 best diss records.
Yeah, for sure. I think Back to Back was one of those.
It's up there.
It was one of those.
It's the best of the modern era.
Yeah. 50 going at Ja Rule all the time. Well, he has so many of them, you know what I'm saying? Like, maybe I'm so disrespectful because to me, you a mystery. I know niggas from your hood, you had no history, never poked nothing, never popped nothing, nigga, stop front, you know what I'm saying? That was all fire shit back then. But
I like Cam'ron's diss against Jay-Z.
For me, one of the ones I always shout out, you know what I'm saying? Though, like, a lot of people don't talk about it, but I like the Gucci's The Truth, man. You know
what No. Gucci's that is so high up there.
Yeah, I like Gucci's The Truth, man. It's not a diss record. It's just the truth. You know what I'm saying? It's just the truth. Like, you know what I'm saying? Dig your partner up, man. Bet he can't say shit. Like, that's some disrespectful shit to say to somebody.
Come on, from the end on six.
Like, that's just like that bar alone is some fucked up shit to say to somebody, homie. Like, you know what I mean? Like, Gucci a terrorist on them records, man. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I definitely rock with that. But, like I say, man, there was a lot of dope diss records back in the day. Like you said, man, Dre Day. You know what I'm saying?
People forget that Dre Day is a diss record. That's a number one hit that was like literally like ubiquitous. You couldn't go anywhere.
You couldn't go anywhere without hearing
the early 90s without hearing Dre Day.
Dre Day and Real Compton City G. That was, you know what I mean? That's the back and forth right there. Those two go at each other hand in hand. I think the videos even both had AJ Johnson in them.
Right. They did. And I think that like I don't give a fuck if it's not lyrical, but here's a Jimmy joke about your mama that you might not like.
She was a Frisco dyke.
Come on, fool. That shit was like.
Come on. And that death row, I hear you getting treated like boot camp. Yeah. Gotta follow the sergeant's directions and get your ass smacked with the Smith and Wesson.
Pay attention to the E's. Same place, don't snap the real motherfucking G's.
Like, come on, man.
I've said this several times, and I'll say it again. One of my top five verses in hip hop history is BG Knockout.
Man,
on
the Knockout.
Definition original baby gangster.
I must be like you are. Thank you.
With my fucking accent. I have to. Dr. Dre, Snoop Doggy Dogg, and fucking active. Gangsters, studio gangsters, buster. This time you're dealing with some real motherfuckers. Jeez. Please.
He was gassing on that motherfucker.
And you can tell
the way he came in, that is just like a.
I think the big
show stole that from him.
Oh yeah.
Well, it's the big show. Right. Come on, BG Knockout. You need to get your money from Big Show.
Get your royalties.
Well, it's the Knockout. You know what I'm saying?
And do you remember the other diss track that those fools made? DPGK.
Oh yeah. Dog Pound.
Dash. Killer. You know what I'm saying? Corrupt. Killer.
You know what I'm saying? Because if you didn't know.
And you know what I'm saying? Of course, Snoop and them, they had that record and it was like dissing the set. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? The Natural Born.
Yep.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? So it was like, that was real tension back then.
Well, and then there's a whole, and then Dog Pound did the What Would You Do?
Yeah.
Like, what do you say?
Yeah. So it was real tension, man. They had to, the fight at the golf course. And
right.
So they had real beef back then. I'm glad them brothers all grew past that. I've seen Knockout and Snoop somewhere recently doing their thing and hanging out. So, but like, yeah, that's the difference between, that's why we appreciate these type of beefs, because those rappers back then, they you say something on the record, it's up. You have to really stand on it when you've seen them. Now, man, we appreciate seeing Drake and Cole and Kendrick and them being able to just spit bars and we can enjoy it. And we ain't got to see nobody die behind it. Like you say, we see the drill rapping and what's happening in that culture. Dudes is getting killed, going to jail, all over these records. So like, you know what I mean, I think them spearheading this shows the younger generation that's in that, like, man, y'all can keep it on this wax. Y'all ain't gotta do all this. Y'all ain't gotta take it that serious. Say what you gotta say on wax, man, and this, and keep it off, and keep it off the streets. You know what I'm saying?
Do you think Cole, cause like so many people have been saying like Cole was getting threats from Compton and he had to I really don't think anyone from, like, you really think that fool's from fucking TDE and it's like just random gang members from Compton were that pressed about this? I know we don't play about Kendrick out here. I don't play about Kendrick. But
think about it, it be shit like this where it's like, and I did see somebody put Games just 300 bars and running. Yeah, that was a fire.
I said that.
That was a fire one. But like, I feel like, you know, you got fans and shit that do go crazy. You know what I'm saying? Like, you do probably have people in people entourages.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That probably, because you got to think at this level of the game, like whoever been real close to Kendrick probably knows J. Cole as well. They've been all around each other. Right. Dude's been running. So it could have been more so for me. I felt like it didn't sit right with him because deep down he's like, I don't even feel this way. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't, but it's like it's hip hop. But in his mind, he probably like, I don't feel this way at all anyway. Like, I'm not really a beef rapper, you know what I'm saying? He even said on the song, like, I don't, like, I get here from the bars. I don't get here from the controversy. So that's the only part I respected, where it's like, if this ain't true to you, then get out the way from it. But at the same time, once you laid it out there, it's like, bro, it's already there, and we all rap. But it's like, if this ain't who you is, then from this point on, you know, like,
he didn't
all
say
that,
nothing that crazy,
he didn't,
though.
No, he didn't. He didn't say nothing
that'd
like,
be like that. That's literally,
got my shooters with me ready to slide. Maybe he thought that was,
that's like me dissing Avo.
Yeah.
Then I get a fucking text from motherfucking Levi.
Yeah,
you
feel me?
Like, hey, I wasn't feeling that, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know, my bad, Avo.
Yeah. Just rapping. We just saying some shit, but.
Because Levi finna beat my ass, bro, next time I see him.
Cold, man.
In Calabasas.
Oh, you let the streets down. K-Dot, we waiting on you. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? We waiting on you. We definitely waiting on you. Speaking of Dish Records, I do want to shed a little bit of light on it. Since we here, Hitman Holla dropped a Dish record on Easy to Block Captain today.
Did he? Can we listen to that?
Yeah, it's called
Ego, right?
Ego. Hitman Holla dropped Ego, and from what I'm hearing, Easy the Block Captain will be dropping one out maybe tomorrow or tonight or whatever. But he dropped a cover art to his with a snippet saying he already done dissing Hitman Holla back, so he's ready to drop his.
Now, I know Hitman's put out some music. I know people enjoy it like that. To me, like, I don't be fucking with Hitman for the music.
Yeah, that's
you,
a fact.
Feel me? Like, I gotta keep it.
Hey, Hitman, I'm trying to battle you. You know, we gonna get that in. But I'm gonna be honest with you about this Dish record when I listened to it.
Yeah.
I did hear a snippet that I liked on it. I think he put it on Instagram and he said, Geechi third round and we still viewing your body. So, hey, you gave me a shout out. So, you got got a point already. But the rest we gonna see. Okay.
Little country St. Louis guitar.
Okay.
I'm so ahead of battle rappers, they can't even tie my shoes. Plus, I'm responsible for most they highest views. To the point I hear him say, I think he buys views. Bunch of dick riders, there's too many buys views. We don't follow orders, don't apply us to the rules. Bunch of red rags, no outside, it's just the rules. Never worry about when we collide with other crews. Playing both sides, they could choose. Man, your ego got way too big, let me get through to you. Heard what Pat did, imagine what I'd do to you. Doing bad biz, that's why that one league suing you. Get you third round with a body, we still viewing you. Know that one saying, you froggy with nigga leap. And bags and bodies ready, your roster is all sheep. I got enough paper to really buy y'all street. Cause you know if the house in the trenches, they all cheap. Been all bad since we battled, man, call me. And I get you right back viral, small fee. I'm really big dog, just swine at y'all, please. You forgot, just look at the numbers on y'all lead. I heard you say you was the reason 225. Death the line down the block, my nigga sigh. Remy don't believe that either. I know why, cause the venue she booked you next, fool, that's a lie. Y'all gassed everything he said to me, all hype. Y'all let the nigga talk about sentiment all night. The world know how I treat my queen while y'all hype. And come to find out you was stalking a nigga wife. He got hot, I told niggas book it, got right on him. His secret was safe in the dark, I put the light on him. Backstage, Pat walked up, put the right on him. Easy got a 40 inch vertical, he took flight on him. I'm finna go nuts, it would've went up. You drunk but can't sober up around Remy too much. Then see me go buck, and any nigga grilling, you fuck. I'm hitman, I'm supposed to want to kill in the tux. I'm willing to truck, no sub, and I'm still in the clutch. Wolves and pit bulls, you ain't dealing with pups. Never ran, like my hands when you dealing with us. Chiller get touched, cold case, sealing them up. Yeah, now nah, late bitch niggas who violate. I don't wanna hear no tough shit from you, retaliate. That was me, I don't care where we at. I'll spray broad day, I'll raise in the sun, so now nah, late. Your little handicap win was cool, but I ain't phased. Man, they booed me before I got to the stage. Ready for war, had to lace up the mic. So glad he volunteered, I'm still mad about the mic. You owe Remy half of this, nigga, drop and give a 50. I don't know where you from, but just stop it with the Philly. But I'm really starting to see why they don't rock with you in Philly. Cause every time I look up, you won't stop from looking silly. Put my money right in my hand, I'm Ray Charles. Hit you with 762s from ARs. I'm worried about anything and ain't sure. If I gave you your first million views, you can't talk. That nigga serious was all in them spaces like he gon' rumble. Then he got the back-to-back L's and I ain't humble. Swapping chest, just both and not a mumble. But what they do, they next battle, they both fumble. Man, I seen enough. This nigga scared of me, so stop bringing him up. A whole nother beast, that's what I'm bringing to Lush. They like hollow or murder mook, hopefully cleaning up. These niggas just wanna be me. This hustle just wanna
That was funny right there.
What's up with Mook? You other niggas is cheesy. I'm shooting at everything associated with ease.
Okay, hit man.
I'm not gonna lie.
Talk about it.
That was hard.
Okay.
Like, I feel like that's some of the most complex bars I've ever heard from Hitman.
Okay, talk about it, man.
I really feel like he... Am I tripping when I say that? Because I've always said this. I'm a big fan of Hitman. He's one of my favorites. Yeah. But the attributes that I admire in Hitman... Now, not to say that he don't got... Because, like, the whole, like, the car, I just bought a car out of the showroom last time he was even sleeping in the showroom. Like he has those moments where he really, but like to me it's like the
performance.
Yeah, and the big and Gerald, what's up? That's how you talk. You know, that's what we love Hitman for. But like I thought that was hard. It dragged on a little at the end. It got a little, you feel me? But for the most part, that's a very dope diss record in the context of battle rap in particular.
Yeah, no, it was definitely dope. You know what I'm saying? Now, it wasn't a kill shot to me.
Not a kill shot.
It was a good record that had some moments in there. Like he was talking this shit. He was fly talking like, I gave you your first million, can't talk to me. You know, if Pap did, imagine what I'd do to you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You out here, man, Remy, you know what I mean? I know you can't sober up, you around Remy too much. You know what I'm saying? We still viewing you. You know what I mean? He had some lines in that joint that was like, you know what I mean? Back to back lines in that joint. He took some shots at the end, like you said, Mook, Swamp Chest, couple dudes. I feel like it's a beatable record though.
It is.
It's beatable. You know what I'm saying?
That now was a lot of easy. He left out.
It's a lot of shit he left out. Lot. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know if he got one in the tuck because Easy can. He we seen him do diss records before. He's came out. So now you got this ain't just about him and nobody else. It's about him and Hitman. So if he go back at him, he can. You know what I mean? Possibly beat that record. But that is a good record right there from Hitman. It was better than probably people thought because I know a lot of people, like you say, lyrical, you know what I mean? That's not really his strong suit, but he came through with some bars in that. He had the energy, you know what I'm saying? Now, I like the beat selection for him. It was a smoother beat for him, you know what I mean? So he kind of like wrote the beat real player. But yeah, I want to see what Easy do and judge them both side by side when Easy drop is and see what's better. But right there, that's a solid one. Ain't a kill shot to me. It ain't one of those where you like, oh, bro, it ain't no coming back from this. You better.
No.
It's like now, it's on you what you got. It's one of those. It's like now it's on you what you got. I gave you something. You know what I'm saying?
I feel like I feel like hopefully this was the jab that he's leading up to an upper.
Yeah, it's just a jab. It's a jab. It gotta be.
But I think what caught me is that like that's like the best I've heard him rap on wax.
Facts.
That's the best I've ever heard him rap on.
I can say that.
By a significant margin.
I can say that. You know what I mean?
So, okay.
I see y'all in the chat. Some people agreeing with me, said it was beatable, but then some people say, yeah, I think it was just a jab. You know what I'm saying? I see my boy Ye Arias said it was just a jab. Gav said beatable. If Easy pick a good beat, that's a W for him. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Eric Chapman said, nah, I feel like he whooped him. You know what I'm saying? Ye Arias said he give it an 8 out of 10. You know what I'm saying? I think that's where I'm at with it. I'm like about 8. I'm at 8.
7.5.
7.5-er? Yeah. 7.5. Yeah, you're right.
I've been you're right, the block and be knocking
I'm
going to slap that Drake song.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm not slapping that one again. So that's what I'm saying. When it comes to, because I'm slapping, no disrespect, but me and Illmac, we drop shots. I'm bumping shots.
Right.
I'm in the whip.
Right.
Yo, Hitman, holler at me, bro.
Yeah.
Can't sleep good, man. You got Gotti at your door. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm bumping that. You know, I think the beat selection. So that's what gave him a 7.5. It was a decent beat for him to ride, but ain't nothing I want to just bump all day. You know what I'm saying? The bars was dope, but it wasn't nothing too crazy to where he was like, let me run that line. It wasn't no run that line back ones. It wasn't none of those. Like, wait, what'd he say?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't one of those where you got to stop it. You know what I'm saying? Like, you feel me? Wasn't none of those yet, but it was a dope track nonetheless. Very beatable. I'm going to give him 7.5. Next time we hear, Easy track should be dropped by then.
Yeah.
And we'll review it. We'll be fair.
And, bro.
We'll be fair. We're going to be fair.
Easy don't fucking, like that. If Easy don't jump over that, you got to leapfrog over that motherfucker.
Yeah, yeah, he got to kill that.
You from Philly, bro.
Come on, you better be able to kill that.
Philly, like.
Come on.
I've said this before, and I'll say it again. The best pound for pound, bar for bar rappers of any city is to me Philly.
Yeah, you got to be able to kill that.
I feel like Philly rappers, they might not have the best music, but just there's so many fools that are just like crazy. Like that era, that early 2000s era of Philly.
Too many.
Unfuckwittable. Like it go Philly, then Detroit to me. Like I'll take that over damn near like over Brooklyn and Harlem type shit. Like when it comes to sheer volume of dope rappers.
Yeah, like, for sure.
Like, so I think Easy should be able to do it. I hope he doesn't do the overly whiny flow.
Yeah, I don't want to hear that the whole time.
Which is,
yo, Hitman, you want to say that you got a problem with me? Yo, Hitman, all you want to talk about is Remy. Yo, Hitman, you know I'm coming out of Philly.
Yeah.
Yo, Hitman. Like, yo, slow, come on, man. Get in a different bag. Don't whine the
use
whole
it
time.
Sometimes.
Yeah, jump in it sometimes.
Do it like Royce the 5'9".
But I don't want the whiny flow the whole track either, though.
Nah.
I don't want this shit to sound like filling in the air.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Like,
and don't be crying.
Don't be giving us no sad diss record.
You know what I'm saying? Rap over the filling in the air.
You know how much coke I used to stir up? You know what I'm saying?
Now you got my emotions all stirred up.
You know what I'm saying? Like, nah, man. Talk your shit, get in your bag. You know what I'm saying? Talk your shit, get in your bag. We want to see it. But for right now, we got Hitman 7.5 out of 10. Diss record. That's a solid, good diss record.
It is.
We want to see more, see what's next. I want to see some more battle rappers jump into the I think Chef Trez dropped one, too, they said, where he kind of dissed a couple people in the culture as well.
Okay.
So we're seeing a lot of people get into that bag. You know,
that's what
the energy is out there.
This is what it's about, fool.
The energy is out there right now.
This is what it's about. And it's like, it's weird, like, in battle rap, I get really impressed how, because in my era, and it's just like, you know, I was really driven by genuine animosity. Like,
big facts.
I had already like battled the homies and shit. We got that off. You feel me? Like, we might, if there's money on the line, we might battle. But like, when it was, if I want to battle you, like, it's damn near like equivalent to a fade.
Yeah. It's definitely equivalent to the fade, you know.
But that's not what time it is. So I'm impressed by fools like you who are able to be good friends.
Yeah.
Like, I'm pretty sure you and Mike B are cool. Well, you feel me? Like, you know what I'm saying?
I ain't seen him in a while. No. Shout out Mike B, Mike, man. I think he out there in Florida. Pull up, boy.
I'm just saying, like there's fools that you've got at super fucking
Definitely, man. Me, I, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't take it serious, man. I'm having fun up there, man. Like, I'm comfortable in my skin. I got my own real shit going on. So when I'm just going at somebody, man, I'm just going at them, man. Hopefully they just.
But you do have different levels, though. Like,
I got levels.
I feel like with Nitty, you left the gloves on.
For sure.
With Illmac, you left the gloves on.
For sure. Like, yeah, I don't have to get in that bag.
Yeah.
It just depends on if that's what it requires. You know what I'm saying? If it requires that, like, you know what? The people really want this. Detailed, like breaking down, like really, that's what they asking for, and I'm gonna give it to them. You know, I can gauge through the way the fans is talking, through the way everything coming up into the battle. I don't think they was asking for that for the Illmac. You know,
no,
man, they wasn't asking for that with me and Nitty. It was more.
It would be
like,
weird to see.
They was
you
asking
Illmac
for that with Easy. They was that. Asking with that for Mike P. They was asking for that with even Ines that just dropped. You know what I'm saying? Me to kind of get more detailed and angle based. You know what I'm saying?
I love the picture of you battling Ines. You look like so genuinely amused.
Oh, man, I had so much fun smoking that boy, man. You know what I'm saying? Rapgrid.com. I do want to say this before we get out of here too. Monopoly 2 is going down, Orlando, Florida. If you're not in the building, I will post this Rap Grid pay-per-view link for you to be able to, you know what I mean, snatch up the pay-per-view, because I know everybody can't be in Orlando, Florida. A lot of our supporters are from different states. You know, can't fly out that weekend. You might just can't make it out there. So that's why the pay-per-view link is there, because you can just watch it at home and you get to see Tay Rock versus A-War, Geechi Gotti versus Loso, Capo versus Shotgun Shug, Eunice versus Franchise, Riggs versus Snake Eyes.
Great card.
L.I. the Mayor versus D.I. the Henny Man, Av versus Don Marino, Billy Boondocks versus Chef Trez. Ooh. And then we got...
That's crazy.
Come on, man. Come on, man.
Boom got to look.
Come on, man. We got
We going to see you, Boom.
Daylight will be in the building because Daylight is playing on the basketball.
I want Billy to show him out. Billy, show us how... We know how good you can be.
Yeah, that's your chance, Billy Boondocks.
This is because you got... You battling
maybe
one
maybe next Thursday before we go or something. If it's possible, I don't know if you know what I mean. If we all going to be here, because I do know there's other events. We about to be flying out. But if we can get a show maybe Tuesday or something, we get Billy... You come here, we give you the opportunity, if you're watching this, to come talk about your battle. You say we don't support you. We giving you one more shot to come talk about this battle. You better cook, too.
Yeah.
You're going all the way to Orlando.
I want Cat Williams. Yeah,
or after your battle, you come up here and you talk about it.
Right.
You come before or after.
But all that freestyle shit, and I know you can freestyle your ass off, but all that freestyle shit you talk, you got one of them.
You got the best. It's the guy.
Yeah, you got one of the
guy right now, man.
Top five freestylers in the game.
This is
not just battle rap, but in the world. Period, like Chef Trez, like, so let's see you on that level, bro. Could be a breakout moment. So shout out to Riot for giving that look.
Definitely.
Now, I think, is it this weekend? The Westworld joint?
Westworld is this weekend. So like we just said, Sunday, y'all be in there for that. Westworld got it going up.
I got a fucking judge again, bro.
Salute my guy, Big K. Finna go kick Appa ass out there and all that battle for me. You know what I'm saying? Since I didn't get to do it, shout out the dog striking again out there. Next week, we got our event on Sunday. I'm still going to show love to my guy, John John. They got an event on Friday. So y'all support that as well if you can. But yeah, we're Sunday. Gotcha, Saturday man. Is a basketball event. So if you out there already for Saturday, you can come check out the basketball games. Like I said, Chef Trez is playing. Daylight is playing. I think Snake Eyes, a couple other battlers are playing. Then we got...
You got hoops like that, fool?
Yeah, I mean, but you know, I don't really like to bring it out. You know what I'm saying?
You ain't got no hoops.
No, I got them though, for sure.
Yeah.
I'm one of them.
You like a Charles Barkley.
Nah, hell no.
Oh, yeah?
I'm still with the handles.
Oh, okay.
I'm that guy.
You
know what I'm saying?
You be dishing?
I fucked my elbow up years ago playing football.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Dislocated it, going hard with it. You know what I'm saying? So my jumper ain't what it used to be.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I can still...
You're balling like an athlete, but ain't got jumper.
Man. Kyrie with the handles, for sure. Kyrie with the handles.
I pictured you as like a Scottie Pippen.
Kyrie,
like,
all day with the handles.
Small forward. Like.
Kyrie with the handles, bro. Nope. Okay, I'm talking about no ripping me.
Really?
All N1 mixtape moves, hot sauce.
You was hot sauce.
I'm one of them. Oh, for sure. Ask about
me. You was the professor.
Oh, definitely.
Black professor.
Can't fuck with me.
Okay.
Give them buckets all day.
Because Day and Hitman and some of these fools, some of these fools really got it like that. So.
Yeah, man. Compton Middle School. We was the Christmas League champions at Walton when I was in middle school. You know what I'm saying? Christmas tournament. Shout out Coach Florence.
Did you go to Compton High?
I went to Compton High.
Yeah. Okay, so I played y'all.
I was gangbanging so hard I didn't get to play sports.
I played y'all.
One, uh,
one game, and then they.
I made my JV hoop team, and I was like the one that they let on the, like, they cut a bunch of people. They let me on because I had the most heart. I'm Kirk.
See, Compton High, they was letting all the bangers play. I ain't gonna lie, but all the bangers really play football. So I remember I played football that one time and shit like that. And we was trash when I went there, man.
We played Compton High, and y'all.
Yeah, we had Coach Ray when I played. You know what I'm saying?
And JVs, I didn't make varsity. I mean, because our varsity, we were motherfucking state champs.
Yeah, shout out Compton High. Now I think it's burned down. They built it back up. Y'all fucked us up in JV though. Damn.
Y'all JV squad fucked us up.
We was trash when I went there. It was
a little bit before. I was
2002, 2002.
This is like when Dominguez was killing it because they had Tayshaun Prince.
06, so yeah, so I was like,
Englewood was crazy because they had Paul Pierce. We had Baron Davis. Yeah. You feel me? Like,
who went there when I went there? When I left Compton High and went to a continuation school at Compton College, then I went to Chavez. But DeMar DeRozan went there when I left.
Yeah, you were there when I left. I was supposed to still be in there,
but I was in a continuation school. But I did get to see DeMar DeRozan play. He played with some of my partners.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Some of my partners played on that team. So shout out DeMar DeRozan. He did go to Compton High for like two seasons.
Come on, man. You know, like DeRozan.
Yeah. And we had an episode with DeMar on those studio one too before. You know what I'm saying? Shout out my guy DeMar, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Compton High. I went to Compton High. Yeah, exactly. We was up there high as a bitch.
Yeah. I know you ain't go to Centennial. That's why.
Didn't go to the 10. Hey, yeah. When I went to Compton High and Centennial couldn't even play each other.
Fuck no.
I think it changed afterwards, but when I went there, it was always fight. They couldn't play each other.
Too activated.
They were the only way they would play is if they would have made it probably to like the playoffs, and both their teams were trash, I believe. Yeah. But I think their basketball team was better than ours that year when my boy Mike Gordon went there, and I think they had Aaron Aflalo.
Okay.
Centennial had a nice squad. But yeah, like, and when I went to Compton High, I think one game they played Centennial football, and it was big old fight on the field, fighting the stands. they exited that out. That was like my ninth grade year.
Then it turns into worse shit.
Yeah, I was over with after that. Oh, can't play each other, you know what I'm saying? So, but salute to the kids that's going there now in these different schools, because I was hearing that they was able to start getting some of those games, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
kids
kind of mature. You feel me?
Kids a little matured it up a little bit, banging, kind of slow down, let them dudes do that.
Make at least that neutral, whatever y'all got
to
do.
Play the sport. Lead the sports to the sport. That's why you can't put the bangers who ain't taking sports serious on the team.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You feel me? That's what, you know, we on the, yeah, nigga, where you from? Nigga on the line and shit, pushing, nigga, fuck your hood.
No trophies. Yeah, no, trophies, ain't taking no trophies.
Yeah, nah, man. Come on, man. We need the niggas who really trying to make it to play. You know what I'm saying? Lead
trophies, not trophies.
Come on, man.
You dig?
You know what I'm saying? But, man, we got Lush Uno here, man. My co-host, shout out, like I said, man, big prayers up for Craig. The money wasn't here today as well, man. He had to work. He had some things going on. You're back at No Jumper. Want to shout that out as well, man.
Salute.
Definitely, man. Good to see you up there, man. So y'all make sure y'all support Lush when you see him over here. Make sure you support Lush when you see him at No Jumper. We also know, you know what I'm saying, he got Lush World going on still, you know. So y'all rock with
Lush. Shout out to Matt D, Lush World. And please stall me out. When you see me judging rap battles, I'm just an old ass man with an opinion. You feel me? Look, man, the attributes that I value in battle rappers are clearly not aged with the times in certain areas. You know what I mean? Because I love what Nitty do. I love what you. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I love, like, you know, Oppa. Some of these youngsters, units are crazy as fuck. You feel me? Like Capo. There's a lot of them, right?
Yeah.
But I'm still a fan of performance, angles, character assassination. That's the era I grew up in. And if you're able to diffuse it and just like overall rapping mechanic skills, like,
for sure.
Just because somebody stacked more punches, which I feel like everyone going to be like, oh, whoever punched the most wins now. Because that's the flavor. You feel me? And there's very few outliers such as yourself who have different styles. If it's not that, it's punch, punch, punch. People got no attention spans. Yeah, they crucify me, and I love that my youngin' Queese. He's a motherfucking killer. You feel me? But I thought Hansel took that shit.
Real talk.
That's just me.
Real talk. I'm not mad at you, man. Hansel got put out. Lush felt like he had it. He out. So now we got Keese versus Dev. We got Clutch versus Next. He will still be a judge.
He will be in the building. I might get a cold that day or
West
something.
World will have it cracking. Yeah, I know what time it is, man.
Come on, man. You know the motherfucking vibes. Good to be back.
Shout out Avo.
holding us down, ruining your day, powering this No Studio and Network podcast, man. Shout out the team, man. We're going to get up out of here, man. Y'all definitely tune in to us, man, weekly, man. We're going to keep it going, man. We got some other shows coming real soon. Like I said, we got a food episode coming out real soon, man, so y'all can keep up with it, see what we got going on, man. We're going to definitely keep the show rolling, get some guests up here. Y'all DM me, DM Lush about guests, too, that y'all want us to start trying to, like, please, bring us up here. We'll try to get it, make it happen. I know y'all.
I'm thinking we should have Brick Baby over here.
Let's bring Brick over here, man. Bring the brick over here, man. Bring Lefty Gunplay through here, man.
Let's bring
my guy DW. We can bring some of them cats through here, man. Let's bring some cats through here, man. We could definitely turn up. I know y'all want to hear from a lot of these dudes. So yeah, man. Y'all let us know too, man, what other cats that y'all want to see come through here, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, if y'all got some suggestions and we can make it happen, definitely make it happen. It don't got to be a battle rapper. Like I say, we talking different people.
Yeah.
It don't have to be battle rapper. It could be anybody. You know what I'm saying? Y'all let us know. We'll make it happen, man. Most definitely. But anything you want to shout out?
Man, with that being said, never counterfeit, about my grip, and we about this beer.
Yeah.
No front, no faking, that's what you be doing. And in my hood, we call that studioing.